This year in Mrs. Abbott's class, we learned volume!
V-O-L-U-M-E, volume. First you get length, multiply back width, and then times height. That's how you find volume.
This year in Miss Abbott's class, we learned about adding and subtracting decimals.
When you add and subtract decimals, you line them up.
This year in Miss Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned how to add fractions.
I don't know art, but I do know math, so you're ready for this lesson in 3, 2, 1.
I got this feeling that fractions will be all divided. We add them, all you do is find the common denominator. Common denominator, common denominator.
This year in Miss Abbott's class, we learned about area.
Length times width. Length times width. Length times width. It would equal area.
That's all we can remember.
This year in Miss Abbott's fifth grade classroom, we're learning how to convert fractions into a decimal.
You must not know how to do this. You must not get this at all.
You must be so confused by this. So just listen to our song.
Never gonna get how to do this. Please just tell me how to do this. 'Cause every time I try, it goes so wrong. Tell me how to do and I'll be right. Just tell me how to do and I'll be right. In case I forget it all next year.
So all you gotta do is divide. Divide the numerator by the denominator. All you gotta do is put a decimal. And after that, you gotta add a zero.
That's how you convert fractions
into a decimal.
This year in Miss Evans' class, we learned about quarter grades.
Marking the school, going to class.
We learned about quarts at last.
All right, listen up. This is what we're gonna do. We're gonna do 5-2, slide 5, walk 2, up 2.
Last we put the point and we get 5-2. Don't forget the point, dude.
This year in Miss Abbott's class, we learned about dividing fractions.
Today on Facts 12 News, kids are trying to learn how to divide fractions. So let's get right to the news. Sing you to one of the forms.
Today we're in Felicity Franklin Schools, and kids are trying to learn how to divide fractions. We're going to Cole Thompson.
Leo here in Heckler is trying to help kids learn about how to divide fractions.
Dividing fractions is easy. All you have to do is keep change for.
That is all. See you tomorrow.
This year in Mrs. Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned Mr. Doll.
How do I multiply and divide decimals? It's too hard.
We can teach you with a little song we like to call Mr. Doll.
Mr. Doll, do 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 do, multiply do 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 do, to the right do 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 do, then divide. To the left do 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 do, to the left do 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 do, to the left do 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 do, to the left. That's the end do 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 do, that's the end do 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 do, that's the end do 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 do, that's the end.
This year in Miss Abby's class we learned about exponents.
What's an exponent?
Should we ask somebody?
We should ask Jamie Kaylin.
You walk into the classroom and see the exponents on the board. All you have to do is multiply the whole number that many times, so you can find the answer.
I get it now. This is easy.
Exponents!
This year, Miss Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned about metric units.
If you don't know what metric units are, a shorter way to remember is King, Henry, Dimension, and Chocolate.
King stands for kilo.
Henry stands for hecto.
Dime stands for deco.
Bi stands for base.
Drinking stands for deso.
Chocolate stands for centa.
Milk stands for mil.
We learned about multiplying whole numbers.
Walk into my classroom, got pencils in our hands.
Take it out to the math line, don't forget to multiply.
Took me like six tries, ain't no curves like the M in multiply.
Math's like a back road, driving with my eyes closed. I know every answer like the back of my hand.
15 times 30, I ain't in no hurry, and the answer is 450.
Ta-da.
This year, Ms. Abbott's class, we learned how to multiply decimals.
When you're multiplying decimals, move it to the right, drop it down light, put it back in sight, and you'll get it right.
Today in class, we're going to learn how to multiply fractions.
How do you multiply fractions?
Well, first, you do top times top. We're going to start out with a simple problem.
Okay.
I think you turn that 2 into 2 of 1.
Yep, you turn it into a fraction. And then we do the bottom.
That equals 2.
Yep.
We did it, Emma.
Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned how to multiply and fractions.
Top times top, bottom times bottom.
Simplify
and
that's
the end.
This year, Ms. Abbott's class, we learned about perimeter.
Perimeter is around, perimeter is around. Oh no, don't you know perimeter is around? You add up all the sides, you add up all the sides. Oh no, don't you know you add up all the sides?
When we do perimeter, we add up all the sides. Right, check your work to make sure it's right. Yeah, oh, this is how we do it. There's no way that we can lose it, because you know me, in perimeter, I need to find, I need to divide. We do this work like lighting up for you guys, no sunshine.
This year in Mrs. Abbott's fifth grade class, we learned about PEMDAS. Okay, class, today we're going to learn about PEMDAS.
It might seem crazy what we're about to say, but please excuse my dear and Sally. Yeah, P is first for parentheses, E is for the exponents, M and D is for multiply and divide. Last is A and S for add or subtract. That
class, we learned place value.
One day morning, walking into school.
Today we're gonna learn about place value.
Start at the decimal, move to the left.
Gonna know your place value, do you know what to do?
Find its identity, multiply it correctly.
6 times 1,000, place value 6,000, find its identity.
Move to the right, hundredths, thousandths. Now I know place value.
The decimal is the most important symbol in place value.
This year, Miss Abbott's fifth grade class learned about quadrilateral,
trapezoid,
rectangle, rhombus,
square, kite.
Stop. What are they all in common? They have four angles and four sides.
This year, Miss Abbott's class learned how to find volume.
What is volume and how do you find it?
Well, volume is how many little things you can fit inside of a 3D shape.
So you have to do 8 times width times height and you get volume?
Yes, and that's how you find volume.